In today's lecture, we will see the sublayers of the data link layer. In today's session, we have three outcomes. We will see what are these three outcomes. Upon the completion of this session, the learner will be able to: outcome number 1, understand the sublayers of data link layer. Outcome number 2, we will know the responsibilities of logical link control, simply LLC, or data link control, DLC. And finally, we will know the responsibilities of MAC sublayer. We will see what are the sublayers of the data link layer. In the YSA reference model, data link layer is in the layer 2. The two sublayers of the data link layer are logical link control sublayer and the MAC sublayer. We can notice that this is the data link layer, which is this. And on top of the data link layer, we have the network layer. To the bottom of the data link layer, we have the physical layer. So data link layer has two sublayers: logical link control sublayer and MAC sublayer. We will see one by one in detail. Firstly, logical link control sublayer. The logical link control LLC or the data link control or DLC sublayer is the first sublayer that we are going to address. So the LLC or the DLC handles communication between upper and the lower layers. So this LLC is dealing with the communication between the upper layers and the lower layers. And is there any specific role for this LLC? Yes, we do have a very specific role for a logic link control or the data link control. And the role is, it takes the network protocol data and adds control information to help deliver the packet to the destination. So this is the layer that deals with the network protocol data. Whatever it receives from the network layer, the control informations are added by the logic link control, because we know one of the services of the data link layers is the flow control. So to do flow control, control informations are needed. So this is the layer that deals with the flow control aspects. So that's it about the logical link control sublayer or the data link control sublayer. We will now move on to the MAC sublayer. In the MAC sublayer, it constitutes the lower sublayer of the data link layer. Yes, the lower sublayer of the data link layer is the MAC sublayer. And it is normally implemented by hardware, typically in the computer network interface card. We normally talk about MAC addresses. So this is the layer that is interacting with the physical layer. So in the physical layer only, we will be having the NIC cards. So this is the layer that has direct interactivity with the physical medium. So it is implemented by hardware, typically in the network interface card. And there are two primary responsibilities of this MAC sublayer. Please note, data link layer has two sublayers. It is logical link control sublayer and MAC sublayer. And this MAC sublayer has two important responsibilities, and they are data encapsulation and media access control. So this is the layer that deals with data encapsulation and media access control. We will see what is data encapsulation now. So we will talk about MAC sublayer's data encapsulation part. In the data encapsulation, the frame assembly before transmission and frame disassembly upon the reception of a frame are done by this data encapsulation. After collecting the data from the network layer, all the control information are added. After adding the control information by the logical link control sublayer, then it starts collecting all the bits of information and finally constructs the frame. Before transmission, frame assembly should be done, and upon reception, frame disassembly should be done. So MAC layer only deals with this data encapsulation. And one more point is also important in data encapsulation. This MAC layer only adds a header and a trailer to the network layer PDU. We know that from the network layer PDU, we get the packet and data link layer receives this packet. This MAC sublayer only is going to add the header and the trailer. After adding the header and the trailer to the network layer PDU, frames are created. So MAC layer is responsible for creation of the frames. There are three primary functions of a MAC sublayer. We will see what are they. The first primary function of a MAC sublayer is framing. The second function of the MAC sublayer is physical addressing or MAC addressing. And finally, error control is also dealt by this MAC sublayer. We have seen there are five services of a data link layer. And the flow control is done by this sublayer, and the remaining four services, such as framing, physical addressing or MAC addressing, error control and media access control, are done by this layer. And before we conclude, we will have some more points about this MAC sublayer. The name itself says that it is the media access control. Whenever frames are created, it is the responsibility of the MAC sublayer to place the frames on the physical medium. So max sublayer is responsible for the placement of frames on the media in the sender side. In the receiver side, the removal of the frames from the media. Suppose if this is the sender, the max sublayer places the frame on the media. In the receiver side, after receiving the frame, the max sublayer in the receiver side removes the frame from the media and directly communicates with the physical layer. Yes, this is the max sublayer which is having a direct contact with the physical layer. And that's it, guys. Now there is an interesting activity for you. The activity is, mention the sublayer that is responsible for the service shown in the table. So we know that these are the 5 services offered by data link layer. Let's be very precise. Take a piece of paper and note what is the sublayer that is responsible for flow control and what is the sublayer that is responsible for framing, physical addressing, error control and access control. Pause this video for a while and carry out this task and compare your answers with the answer that I am depicting now. And here is the answer. So flow control is done by logical link control or the data link control sublayer, and framing, physical addressing, error control, access control are dealt by the max sublayer. And that's it, guys. We know data link layer has 2 sublayers, LLC and MAC. I hope now you understood the sublayers of data link layer, know the responsibilities of logical link control or data link control, and know the responsibilities of MAC sublayer. I hope you guys enjoyed the session and thank you for watching.